that was going to be called, but will have additional fighting majors.
And a heavyweight bout at that. Boy, I'll tell you. Bob Colbert just stalled out. Looks like he's cut between the eyes. And Dave Richter of the Flyers.
Second period. There's a kick out the center ice. The Flyers bumped off the puck. Red Wing then has Colbert hit hard, and maybe that's the answer. Flyers along the far side, trying to shift it in.
And we got a Flyer. John Barrett knocked the Philadelphia Flyers into the player bench on the far side. Now we're going to get a penalty. And on the near side, Barrett grabs a hold of the player. He checked Rick Sutter.
And we got a couple of fights going on now. Rick Sutter was with Barrett, and I think it was Colbert and Rick talking, and they're up around the blue lines, and they're really throwing the punches. That Colbert is now, Tockett's landing some punches, but Colbert's landed a number of them.
Tockett just gave him two butts, and that could be a gross misconduct penalty if Bob Hodges refuses to advise the referee of that.
Now, Colbert just gave Tockett a butt.
That'll be Colbert and Barrett for the Red Wings, and Tockett and Rick Sutter for Philadelphia, but Rick Sutter disappeared into the Flyer player bench on that shot by John Barrett.
I tell you, that young Colbert can really throw. He has really been able to handle it. Tockett gave Rick Sutter a pass, and as Sutter was looking back to pick it up, he took it, knew he was going to get hit, but holy cow, Barrett just nailed him right over the boards of the Flyers' penalty box.
Bob Probert, one of his players, used a headbutt to knock Bob McGillen. That infraction drew a match penalty. The referee called it by the book, and a subsequent four-game suspension was handed down.
And Bob Probert, is the one that hammers him, so he'll have a suspension. Lane Lambert was the first out.
Broke out, and yeah, look at that one. That's Bob Probert of Detroit.
The rookie gets his 13th down. Major brawl, Bob Probert versus Kevin McGuire. This is a serious punch out here. And
Ireland give it to Dewey Foster pretty good early in the hockey game, and I'm sure Probert remembered that. Said, well, try some of your own size. Probert got in the first puck, it looked like, and not Ireland working over the back of Probert's top. Oh! He stuck that right hand in pretty good. Robert's got to be careful there, grabbing his hair.
Yeah, he did. Here comes the helmet. Now he's a couple of heavyweights, I'm going to tell you. Look at them pulling hair and banging each other with helmets.
Well, Nyland is pulling the hair too, so they're both,
they're both going to be gone. There's no question. Now he's trying to butt him. He's trying to butt him with the head.
Doing pretty good there, and then when he
well, they don't come any bigger than these two guys, and they can both throw them pretty good. That's a tough job for those two linesmen, the little guys, to get in there. Velvet and Nyland will both be out of the hockey game for sure.
Nyland Scampanello making sure that Probert doesn't get anywhere near Nyland.
That's the front over his right eye, is it?
Well, he had going pretty good, but he was jumping back to Probert's helmet.
He did, and Probert definitely got a couple of good whacks in himself, boy. He hit-butted him, smacking him.
behind the play, and they say, let's go. He's got two of the biggest heavyweights as you'll get in the National Hockey League. Nobody wants to get between those two right now, I'll tell you. They're going to let them tire themselves out. Probert does land one real good punch when they break off the boards. Nyland pounds on the helmet and then rips it off the back of his head and starts hitting him with it.
Probert's got the right hand.
Right there is where he really nailed Nyland with the right hand. Nyland's got to have a sore hand from where. Now let's have a little hair. Now let's take the helmets off, give him a smack with it.
Aaron and Probert for Detroit. Probert, he has to call out a four-game suspension, and he's been a Tiger for the Wings. And Probert.
Watch the Bruin bench as the guy's jockeying for position on the dasher to get a better view. Well, that didn't take long.
Probert just back from a four-game suspension with the score lost in 2, Detroit nothing, over the line. By Kluzak. And here they go. Probert and Kluzak.
They're going to wear each other out. They're each waiting for the other one to throw a punch so they can land a little closer. Gordy keeps hitting Probert's shoulder pad.
Say, well, we're down 2-0 on the scoreboard, but gosh, I bet we're ahead on the fights.
Gordy's helmet's down over his eyes now. I don't know if he can see who he's trying to hit. They're going to be tired. Probert looks like he's having trouble getting that right around.
Well, this might be a pretty good game once they start playing hockey.
Well, finally, the two combatants are just plumb tuckered out.
They'll need an extra intermission to get their energy back.
Well, for some reason, there are some clubs around the league that still think the big bad Bruins of the early 70s are in this building. They feel they've got to come out and fight every day. Probert's already got the stick down. Now he says, well, I haven't got a stick, might as well go. Here I am.
At this point, it looked like it was just going to be a wrestling match, but you know what? These two guys, the punches are going to come sooner or later.
They both dropped the gloves, and look at this. Two heavyweights, pair of 24s, Probert and Plett. You knew this was coming. But the line's been getting quickly, and the fans heavily boo, but they don't see the couple of big fellas get at each other. They like to see that one-on-one stuff as much as anything else. Now, Probert was fighting the puck at center ice just a moment ago. It was in his feet, and to be continued. They didn't get a whole lot of punches on.
We're back, and we've got one of the best fights we've seen all year. Wendell Clark and Bob Probert squaring off at center ice. Clark got in 2 or 3 tremendous punches early on Probert, and then Probert answered with a few.
Well, you know what happened is Probert wasn't going to fight with him right off the bat, and he was going to step back and let Clark get the penalty. And you know why Probert's in there with Clark, and that's because Clark was pushing and shoving. They're squared off already. Well, let's see what happens.
Probert is not going to back away
That's right.
Oh, Probert got that right hand free.
He has got the hand free, and Hunter is a tough guy. Oh, did he ever nail Hunter with a right? My goodness. And Hunter just trying to hide his head now and get away. Big return by Hunter. Boy, these two are the heaviest of heavyweights. You can bet on it. Oh, boy, look at that. My goodness.
Boy, that one could have...
You know, that is not bad when two people square off like that. They're both tough guys. They both want to go fine and dandy. Let them go. Nothing wrong with that. Had a little frustration.
Here comes Secord right over after Probert, and here they go.
McCray got a hold of Secord now.
Probert and Nylund. Probert and Nylund.
This should be a dandy. Get out. This all started after Chicago scored and somebody took a run at Probert.
It was Secord that went over and took the run. Now Nylund wants the ball.
Boys, look out. You're going to get dangerous. Norwood now an old check. Secord and McCray. Nylund and Probert. You've got some heavyweights out there right now.
Probert.
Nylund and Probert are going to get loose and look out, boy, if they do, the two of them. Nylund now, right now, hammering Probert. Yes. Don't understand why.
Probert got the right hand free.
He's loose with the right hand, and he starts to retaliate, and down goes Nylund. And the two of them are hammering each other. Look at it. My goodness.
Well, this all started when Secord...
The two of them just both right-hander, and they're holding with the left and trying to hammer with the... Look at this. This is where fighting can be very dangerous, and somebody can get hurt. Boy, oh, boy.
Well, that's tiring,
don't
too.
Don't get old. Probert with an upper right.
Now, look at this. Probert decked Nylund. He decked him.
My goodness, he is down and hurt. And the referee, look at, he hurt Gary Nylund, and he's still down. Wow. I can't believe how Probert decked Gary Nylund and knocked him cold for a moment.
Yeah.
My goodness. Oh. It's unbelievable, those two going at it.
Oh. Nylund, as he was skating off the ice, he looked over and he pointed at Probert and just said, next time, big fella.
I'm sure there will be a next time, but my goodness. That is as heavyweight a fight as you ever want to see. And those two, when they get loose and nobody's around, it can be awful dangerous. And Probert just decked him. I think he was out for a few seconds. Probert's still on the ice. I can't believe they haven't gotten him off. Nylund is gone. I mean, he was out. They got him up, and he went straight down to the other end. Oh, boy, boy.
Let's take a look at the end of that fight. Here it is.
The two big boys. Watch what happens. Probert coming with an uppercut. Look at this. Oh, yeah. Did you ever knock him down? Gee. Both of those guys.